I think the only real guarantee that, that the land will be managed in a sensitive and careful and sustainable way is if it's in public ownership.
The Friends of the Earth are certainly not friendly with the council recently. Dave Bands and the group Keep Our Downs Public gathered outside Brighton and Hove City Council's Policy, Resources and Growth Committee so they could put pressure on councillors before a vote on the sale of the Downlands. Many would call this action futile, but it looks like this gesture had a part to play in the eventual decision to put the plans on hold. Chris Todd, member of the Brighton Hove Friends of the Earth, thinks that this type of action is what's needed.
You know, we've had that demonstration, we've had a lot of lobbying going on, and we've done others as well where it's been quite clear that just, you know, a show of public concern like that, which doesn't necessarily happen that often anymore outside council committees, does wake politicians up.
For those concerned with environmental protection, the sale of the Downlands is not the only fight to be had, as they are currently fighting a proposed car park in Stanmer Park. The proposals would see a 50% increase in car parking, with the building of a superstore-sized car park at the centre.
The sale of the Downlands has been mooted as they need the money to put into Stanmer Park. Now, our understanding is actually they've raised more than they need to put into Stanmer Park, but it's been frittered away elsewhere on other projects. It's a public resource for public good, but it's not treated like that at the moment.
With the council facing its toughest ever year as government cuts funding to local councils, many services considered by some to be essential, like youth services, charities helping victims of sexual and domestic abuse, are feeling the crunch as the council tightens its purse strings. Some would say that in the current economical climate, environmental issues should take a back burner. Chris Todd argues, however, that a stitch in time could save nine.
We keep ignoring the impact of the how we treat the environment, whether it's on climate change. We're already seeing huge increases in costs in flood defences, in sea defences. Those are direct costs of things like climate change, for example. Things like green spaces, which people, parks and open spaces, people sometimes think they're sort of nice luxuries. But actually there's increasing evidence showing that they're really important for public mental and physical well-being.
This is Jodie Doherty-Cove for Latest TV News.